The lesson for today is called Wiggling Worms, and it's from the Picture Perfect Science lesson book. It goes along with what we've been studying recently in our science curriculum. We're working on food chains. And so at the end of the food chains, we have the decomposers. And so I thought this would be a kind of a good lesson to continue that or follow up with that. The engage part is when there's a teacher read aloud. And the book that I'm using is called Diary of a Worm. And it's a fiction book. It's very humorous. It has cute pictures of worms. All right, Diary of a Worm. Mom says there are three things I should always remember. One, the earth gives us everything we need. Two, when we dig tunnels, we help take care of the earth. Must make tunnel, help earth breathe. That's what the worm is thinking. And the third thing is, never bother Daddy when he's eating the newspaper. It will provoke some questioning, I'm hoping, from the students as they look at the book and see things that it says worms can do. They have to decide, you know, do worms really do that or not? So. The next step is the explore, and the students are going to have an earthworm on a plate that they get to observe. And they will use a hand lens and make some drawings of what they see and collect some data, measure their worm, the length and the width. That's kind of the observation or the explore part. Okay, have you drawn your earthworm? Have you labeled the head, the tail, and the saddle? Okay, good. Head, saddle. Okay, you didn't spell tail right. It's when the light bulb goes on, when they make those connections, that's just wonderful. We talked a little bit in class about worms, and they were saying, how do worms have blood? And one student said, oh yeah, when you put them on the hook, you see the blood come out. It was just like, wow, okay, there's a connection. You've had an experience with worms, and you have something to share, you know. They're just delightful, and I found that I personally enjoy the plants and animals and the life science and earth science. Those are my favorite things to teach.
Slimy. It's slimy. Okay. Feels slimy.
What does he do when we touch him? Does he do anything? Don't
move a bit.
It wiggles around. It did curl up. That's right.
They have they're called worm journals for this particular lesson. They will record their data in the worm journals. There's several different parts. There's predictions to make, data to collect, and a writing activity, how an earthworm helps the environment, how an earthworm grows and survives. They just kind of pull in all their information. To start the experiment, they're going to make a prediction of whether they think a worm prefers a wet or dry environment. And we will place two worms in a chamber, and one side has a wet paper towel and one side has a dry paper towel. And they will leave the worms in there for about 10 minutes, and then they will check on them to see which they prefer.
What's yours?
Look at that one.
Now where'd he go? What is that? Hey, he's squishy.
The evaluation part is after we've completed the activities to see if they can make a poster to show what they've learned about how earthworms are beneficial. They're going to try to convince a fictional person that they should not spray pesticides and kill the earthworms. So it'll show me if they can list some of the adaptations on their poster that worms have, and they can understand how they're beneficial to the environment. I kind of got thrown into science when I was in fourth grade. We departmentalized, and I was the lucky one to get to do science. At first, I was really scared, and I think a lot of elementary teachers they don't feel confident about teaching science. All I can say is get in there and do it, because hands-on, it's just like for the kids. They love hands-on things, and once you do it, you start to develop a love for it. Don't be afraid of it. It's fun. You don't have to be, you know, you don't have to be a genius or have a huge background in science to teach elementary science. You just, you know, get in there and you learn by doing it.